All right. How's it going? It's going to be episode 7 of my Connoisseur Cannabis blog. And today, we have something pretty special for you. Let me pop my back real quick. All right. So today, what we're gonna do?
We got this going. So right there, that is some Chem4 / Alien OG that I already grinded up and
put in there. And so we're gonna get this going in a second, but we. I'm gonna do a little bit of a pot pie, although it's gonna be a medley because it's gonna be that Chem4 / Alien OG. I have here some Chronic Creations Wex
that you may or may not have already seen before. It's a little crumbly.
It's at the end of the little container, but we're gonna put some of this here in the center of the bowl. Make it nice and tasty. Oh, damn. Sent it spinning there. Shit, where'd that little chunk go? There it is. All right, I think that's probably plenty. I spread it out a little more than I wanted to, but there's definitely a decent amount in there. As you saw, that stuff's more yellow than the very green buds that are in there, so you can probably see it all in there. This is going to be pretty intense, I'm guessing. And then, as you may have seen in the last episode, which was a short one, which this one may very well be as well. Some of the best smelling shit I have ever had in my entire life. Some goat wreck haze for you. Yeah, look at that fat ass nug right there. I gotta show that again because it's ridiculous. Look at that. That is beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful. So, I am saving this. but I do happen to have a little right here, so I'm going to use this guy. Like I said, some of the dankest dank you could ever find. And this stuff, I'm going to break up with my fingers because it just melts. And that is the best feeling in the world. So you can't, you know, forsake such an opportunity. All right. Right. So we're getting this guy nice and topped off. I hope you were able to catch the last episode because it was kind of a special one. It was short, but it features one of my good friends from high school, and he's a really cool dude. And so if you haven't seen it, go back just one episode and check it out, and hopefully you'll enjoy it. We did something something to his car today. Replaced his diverter valve or something, I think he said, for his turboed VW that he's got. It was pretty badass, I'm not gonna lie. Freaked me the fuck out the first time I rode in it, because with that little thing, you wouldn't think it's that badass, but he fucking... he stepped on it, and it chucked me against the seat, no lie. I was grabbing for anything I could find to hold on to. Yeah! Oh, okay, it wasn't that bad, but... alright. So this is... oh, man, this is going to be one of the best freaking pot pies I've ever had right here. Mmm. Oh, yeah. Okay. This is smelling delicious. Alright, let's do this shit. Let's get, that's fine. Alright. Got a little, burgundy going on. Been sitting for a while. It fermented a little more, so it's more sour. And more alcohol too. Charging up my vape over here. You know, the reason the last episode was so short, I don't think Dylan has the patience. But, no, I'm just kidding. Actually, my phone died. It's actually my old phone. It's my old Galaxy S4 or something like that. It's an old-ass phone. And I don't use it for anything but this now, pretty much. And so, the battery life is shit, because I've had it for so long, never replaced the battery. So, it literally, like, I charged it 100% today, haven't even touched it, turned it on to use it just now, and it was already at 94%. So I was like, oh, that's wonderful. It really does have a shit battery. But I don't know if you can see that. I packed it in. This thing is perfect. Look at that. Pack it in there with that. This is going to be nice. This is going to probably hurt a little bit. So pray for me on this one. Smell and taste that wax. It's already starting to get it. I don't think I got a full on one though. That was nice though. I've been fighting a cold too. Thank God I'm not sneezing like crazy anymore, but I'll still cough. It'll still make me choke either way. But it's a little harder not to choke when you're kind of sick and you've got that tickle going on, you know? Always got to cough. There it is again. I tasted it. Still don't think I caught it, though, because it's, it'll probably cherry up real bad once I hit it. Thank you. Let's see here. I actually want to catch something here. Oh, fuck. Oh, well. I was trying to go back, and it's on shuffle, so it, like, forgets the last song, like, apparently. It's really stupid, because it doesn't actually do that on my Zoom. So, don't know what's up with that. Oh, I can show you something really cool that I learned. Here, let me take another hit for you real quick, and I'll show you something that I picked up here. So there's that, but I'll find you, hang on a sec, I'm gonna find you something really freaking cool. No! Come on, where is it? There it is. Okay, so, this is a classic song. Now, I don't know the origin of it, like, specifically where it comes from, but I would guess, like, England or something like that, European. It's a very old song, originally. It's been covered tons and tons of times. In this case, it is Lorena McKennitt on her album The Visit from 1991. And if you listen, there's this medley. Medley? That's a medley. There's a melody in the background. It's a lot softer in her music, and it's a lot more atmospheric. But it's really neat, because the melody is, it flows so beautifully, and you can do it in just about any way and make it sound good. The name of the song? My mom actually has a painting that was inspired by this, the idea of it, or maybe the song itself, but it shows a knight, basically, it looks as if he is attempting to woo this, you know, this beautiful lady that's walking up, in the painting, she's walking up these stairs, you know. And she sort of turned away and sort of looking as if she's trying to depart from him, yet he has her hand, and he's kissing her hand. I think that's really neat. But either way, so in my case, I am in what I believe to be drop A. I could be a little out of tune. We'll see here. Okay. So, and this is going to actually sound more like the original. I just pulled this out of my ass listening to this song yesterday, so I'm going to have to fiddle with it a little bit, but it's basically something like No, I remember it now. And then I fuck that part up. Up right there with that little hammer on that I did. But yeah, that's the essence of it. I mean, I just tried to find it something that sounded halfway decent in this tuning, and that's what I kind of came up with, you the gist of it. I thought it was neat. I got it, like, this close a couple of times. So it was okay. I hope you could appreciate that. I'm gonna take that and do something with it, so. If you've made it this far into the video, I will share a little secret with you. I have a second YouTube page, and it is under the name Monster Mosh. So, M-A-H-N-S-T-E-R-M-O-S-H on YouTube. If you would like to check that out, that has all my music shit on it. I ask with confidence in you that you will not mention this channel on that channel. You can, however, mention the other channel on this one to an extent. I don't want anybody that is, well, you know what? Fuck it. My family probably doesn't follow me anyway. So, still, let's try to keep these two things separate projects. I appreciate so much the fact that you've stuck around to watch this, if you indeed are doing so right now. So thank you very much for that, and I look forward to hearing from you. If you feel the urge, go on and shout out in the comments or do whatever. I like to get any kind of feedback. It doesn't really matter. Let me get some constructive criticism and whatnot. I was definitely the wax. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Oh, hell no. Oh. Well, you just witnessed that. That's what's special about Raw and Uncut. Normally people would be like, that was fucked up. I'm editing that out. It was pretty gnarly. It's kind of gross, but that's what's real, man. Hot damn. Yeah, I think I fucking majorly caught that wax, man. Oh yeah, because I am stoned to the bone now. Like, I was high before that hit. Now I'm fucked up. Alright. So again, that was, well, going in order of lit to cached, that would be the Goat Wreck Haze on the top there. Some Chronic Creations Sweet Tooth wax in the middle there. Made a little pot pie on top of some Chem 4 / Alien OG. That Alien OG is testing at 25%. The Goat Wreck Haze is going to be 19.4, which isn't all that high, yet you'd be surprised. This is a great strain. I don't care who you are, medicinal, recreational. I am smoking for my first time, don't know what the fuck I'm doing. This shit's great. It is just beautiful. Gotta love it. I have had Golden Goat in the past, and it was actually really damn good, but not as good as this shit. Hot diggity damn. Woof. Just before this, I was watching Vikings. I'm just watching it from the beginning, and it's already pretty interesting. I'm looking forward to checking that out. Been watching Stranger Things as well. Don't know if people have been watching that. It's definitely going to keep you hooked on it, but I honestly can't tell you if it's worth it or not. You'd have to see for yourself, I suppose. It's a little cheesy at times, but it's kind of interesting. Waiting for The Walking Dead to come back on. I think that's happening like the 20-something of this month. And it is officially October, so we may or may not be getting in the Halloween spirit a little bit soon. We'll see about that. So keep an eye out for that. Maybe find some special buds that were grown, you know, just for Halloween that, you know, maybe just for shits and giggles, got some interesting names to them or whatever, but, you know, we'll see what we come across. Maybe find some Halloween themed edibles or something like that. Although, that's not really, it's just something to show you. And I mean, I guess I could always, shit, yeah, I'll just pause it and keep it charged and wait till that shit kicks in, and then I'll start doing the vlog and be like telling you how it is. And I'm taking it easy on this vape pen. I don't know why. I think it's because I'm sick, but it's making me choke. Like, I normally do not choke on my vape. If you've watched, you know, previous episodes, you know that. I feel sad. I feel kind of pathetic. Help me. Help me. Looking for some new shock. Sure, why not? Oh shit, son. Oh shit, son. wanted. There we go.
There are going to be ups and downs during the course of my presence. And I think I said earlier on in the morning, I'm not a perfect man, and I will not be a perfect president.
All right. That's what I'm talking about. You saw what happens when I try to hardcore dance in here. If you saw that episode, I think that was episode 5. And I freaking started moshing it out with Sam, and I fucking knocked the bong water into my laptop. Luckily, it still works fine as far as I can tell. I'm not having any issues with it, but yeah. So, we're not gonna try and do that. But this is a cool song. Whew! Damn, okay, we're coming up on 30 minutes, y'all. But I'm gonna let you rock out to the song. Okay. Right. I think I put too much in. No, that ain't gonna work. That's a bad idea anyway. Shit makes me sneeze sometimes anyways, and I'm gonna go and do that now. Man, my cops are getting violent now. Here we go, folks. Woo! Well, you just saw that fail. Watch. Shit was definitely stale by then. Fuck. Well, you just got to witness that, so I hope you enjoyed that. I'm all fucked up now. I'm gonna finish watching my show and then probably go to bed. Catch you next time. Peace.